Okay, so this is my SummerSlam match with Fivec. Fivec is since a UK player. Seen a couple videos with him playing from Mystic Juicer. So I knew what I was getting into right away. As far as my game plan, it's pretty much the same as any game plan with Oni. Hopefully here I can burn her down before she burns me down, and I should because I have the life lead and I take huge chunks, so it's not going to take many combats to do it. So far, my normal opens is open with the block just to kind of get the hand a little better. My hand's not super bad, it's not super good, but I think the difficulty of sets is how she plays. Is not random, but I mean, could open into dodge, can open into throws, can open into attack. It could be any of them, and you guess wrong, all of a sudden you're taking a bunch of damage and she's drawing a new hand. I decided here, since I got the three threes early, to go for an early ace play. I'm hoping to get some clockwork soldiers on the table. The other possibility is a martial law because I don't have any face cards right yet. And there's one right now. But I think my initial thought was to do clockwork and try to get that in so I can try to take some really big chunks with just a couple of combats. Because I think my chances of winning this game is really going to come down to maximizing my damage at all times. I'm looking at the seventh row because it feels like a good time for them to dodge. With only five cards, or I believe six cards, I think it was five cards. Maybe I'm wrong, but only five cards in hand can easily dump the rest of the hand. So, the hope there was to just catch that. However, I didn't really have anything I wanted to pitch. I didn't want to pitch the seven throw. I didn't want to pitch the general's armor, in case I get knocked down. I'm looking at a possible clockwork soldier play, so I didn't want to dump the Q. Obviously, don't want to dump the 10. The only thing I could really dump was the 8, and just wasn't worth it. So, might not have been the best call. So, I think that's where my only play is really struggling right now, is that I'm not thinking through my turns. I'm just kind of going, I think they're going to do this, and then play the card. I'm not really looking at my options properly. And not really evaluating them properly. I also think it's a combination of me not understanding fundamentals very well, which I'm starting to realize Oni's not the best as far as learning fundamentals. And that's because you're going to do stuff like throwing out 10 attacks raw, which is not something that you would normally do. Most of them even have 10 attacks, but the way Oni's innate works and everything else kind of changes how you would play the game. From a typical character. Sure, every character has their own niches and ways they play, but this is just one of those things, so that I feel like is going to be a problem for me. There, I was trying to see. I don't understand why we do the Q there. Her Q beats my Q handily. I think I mean, I was thinking throw based on how much hand size was left. Which case, if I was thinking throw, that would have been a perfect time for the 10. So, but unfortunately, it didn't work out that way, and I certainly didn't make the right play. If I was going to think attack, I should have played the 10. But anyways, going back to the previous thing, so I'm actually going to be this is probably my last Oni main open for now. I definitely want to come back to the character. I like the character. I like what he does, but I don't think I'm ready for him. I'm actually thinking about Grave or Gwen. And the reason is because Graves kind of an all-around character, and Gwen, even though she has the disadvantage of the life problem, losing life every turn, you don't have to worry about hand management. You can really worry about, okay, what's my best option here? Don't have to worry about getting on the bad hand, and it's kind of fun trying drawing two cards a turn and everything else. But I think at least it's closer to learning fundamentals than somebody like Oni. All right, so back in the match in progress. Really, not much has happened other than I have not guessed correctly. And again, I think it's, I gotta get eliminate the guesswork and just play what I can play and play to my strengths of my hand rather than worrying too much about reads. Reads are important, but they're not, I think for me as a new player, is not so important. Then learning learning matchups and learning how to use my hand. I think you do have to make the hard read every once in a while. And again, this is one of the reasons why I think Oni is not right for me right now. It's because one important aspect is reading when's the right time to throw out the raw 10. And it's a huge part of his game. I mean, it's 20 damage if you land it and if you do it the right time. So it's a very important thing. Here I'm getting dodged like crazy. And I feel like what I'm thinking in my head is that, okay, he's throwing a bunch of dodges. Starting to run a little low on them. I'm going to go ahead and you know, I'm going to attack. Because I don't think he's got the dodge anymore. I attack with my quick attacks. And he just basically just kept on hitting the dodge button. And it's not that I'm not willing to throw. I definitely am willing to throw with Oni. I've shown that I'm willing to throw with Oni with my first match through all the time. But I may not be as prone to throw with against Itsuke, given the fact that the only thing I really have to worry about, especially the way Fivec plays it, I know that he does not block. Like, blocking, he's said on record that blocking is one of the worst things to do. Now, I don't know how the video was that I saw that on, and maybe he's changed his mind on that, but I did not have it in his range that he was going to block at all, especially against Oni. So throws to me seemed a worse option, especially that I don't have an advantage on throws in the sense of we're just going to clash if we hit, which I guess is still a win, but I don't know. So here I get thrown again. Looking at my hand, why was I blocking? I don't know. I still have an aces back that I could have thrown out there. I had the seventh row that I still had, but again, this is the problem. I get kind of behind. I get in a situation and I stop thinking. I don't slow down. I don't take my time. I just kind of look at a few things and it's like, okay, this feels good. Go. And it's gonna cause me a problem. So I'm not even sure what the hell that I'm doing with the J here. I think it was because I was thinking final authority behind to try to knock them down. So try to knock down Fivec, but again, I'm just going to get dodged out of my shoes. I definitely should have thrown out the seventh row. Face down with the general's armor. Yeah, that's a good idea. The eight was there. I wasn't going to use the eight. The 8 was a fine card to put face down, but as you can see, I'm just making mistakes left and right. And yes, you can, as we go through the video, you can see that it's going to cost me quite a bit. So there's the first match, the 5-ack, pretty handily. I dealt 7 damage to him, which was one throw that I did not pump. Not good. This already kind of set me in a spiral. I was already thinking here about switching to Zane. Because that was part of my game plan, was to switch to Zane if I couldn't make it work with Oni. But I stuck with it at least this game. You may hear some doggy noises now. Dog wanted to sit on my lap. This is Francis, if you hear him. As he sniffs the mic. Francis is a pug, for those who care. And you might have seen back when my icon, before he was Handsome Jack, when we started the SummerSlam, was a picture of him. So if you're wondering where that comes from. Oh, it's on my YouTube channel too. So that's the picture. Anyway, so I don't even remember what the hell I put down. I guess we'll find out in a second. So I have my choices of Jack, block. Okay, so I blocked. Okay, so it's my usual open. He's gonna end up with two aces. Now my queen's really not the best
card against his queen, but it works really good against the aces. And as you can see here, I'm not even considering it, which is odd. I think the queen here would be a good open if I'm going to attack. Oh, see, there we go. Okay. Another block would have been fine too. But as you can see, I don't know if that was a read thing. If he drew the queen, it was like a slight evaluation trap or not. But it was still a good move to do the queen, just because I had the joker behind. So if he did beat me with his queen, I could just take one damage and draw two cards. So I actually, that's seemed like an okay play to me. So now I have the 7, I have the 10, I have the jacks, I have another queen, and I could also dodge. So I don't think I'm ready for the 10s yet. I could throw, being a speed of the fox turn. Another choice would be to dodge into it, which looks like I did. I don't know why I didn't use 4. I think the 4 should have been used as a dodge, because the 2 block is a better block for the 5 and the 7. Oh, yeah. I forgot about that turn. So, well, I didn't forget. I just I forgot that was coming up. So I got so excited, and as you can see, I hadn't flipped my 10s over to the attack side. Normally, I'll throw it on the side that I'm thinking of using it for, although I don't know why I haven't. Like, the 7 is still sitting on the block side, which normally I would have that sitting on the throw side. So I just threw it out there. And when I threw it out there, I threw it on the throw side, not the attack side after the dodge. Worst, not a great move. And I think at this point, that was it. My mind is already dusted. So definite execution error on my part. And it cost me 6 damage. I don't think it became relevant. It might have. But definitely a problem. I'm not sure about the 7 throw here. I don't really have anything to pitch to it. And I think in this matchup, if I hit the throw, I really need to pitch full value. So I think the 7 throw was a bad call. Really, my choices were either to 10 attack, thinking he might throw, or queen to try to catch his aces. And that was it. That's really annoying. I don't think I had much there. I could have blocked with a 5, I guess, if I didn't feel comfortable with those other two. And that seems to be what I'm doing in this particular turn, which I think is correct. I haven't really seen... I think I've seen 1 throw at this point from him as an open. I think with this hand... I really can't look at doing a jack. I could have done the jack of hearts, pitching the 7 of hearts to the final authority to get 20 damage in and getting the knockdown. I am prone to save that, however. There's that throw that he's finally going for. So that could have been a move. The 10 throw again, the 10 attack, although it's been really hard to kind of gauge that because he has been light on his throws. So at that point, I think I was holding it for dodge, my own 7 throw, though there was nothing to pitch for it. So that wouldn't have worked out. So, but now I'm in a situation where I think the queen is the best opportunity I have here. I don't have anything to pitch with the 7. The other choice would be the jack of hearts into final authority backup, which is the play I went for. Just to get myself back on my feet and then deal 20. This is not hard. I'm just going to will-mill that in, even if he puts a face down. He does have the joker, but there's not much I can do. With sets, it's just, you got to. We had a decent crowd. I think they were for Fivec, but I'm glad that we had it. I did make kind of a fool of myself with that 10 play, but you know, it's kind of cool. It's nice having that crowd, even if they're not necessarily on your side or anybody's side. It's cool. And so far, I really enjoy everybody's commentary in the community. So on the forums and on Twitch and on YouTube, it's definitely gotten me to want to keep playing this game. So thanks for everybody in the Yomiya community. All right, so after the Final Authority play, I'm in kind of rough shape with my hand. And I think Fivec knows that. Oni with a 5-card hand is not great. And there I lost my last block. It's a good throw opportunity for him. That's a particular point where I feel like that was an important spot for me to figure out whether he was going to throw or not. Like, it doesn't matter my evaluation in hand at that point. I really have to figure out, okay, is he going to throw? Does he know on my low hand here that I'm definitely going to block a majority of the time? If so, throw at the 10. Because at least I get the draw on it. And even if it's a bad card, I could pitch that, or I could pitch the single ace, because that single ace, or the single king, because neither of them are doing anything for me. So that could have been an opportunity for 20 damage. Now I'm in really big trouble. That block was really important to keep. So maybe even from a valuation standpoint, that means the 10 was a better card than the block. And I'm thinking here, 10 is really the only option I got, which I got in there, which is good. The 2 is a really good one. I'm just going to pitch the single ace. And unfortunately, he saved himself 20 damage from the block. And then there's the 6 damage from the... not block, from the Jokers. And then there's the 6... There's the 6 damage from the error. So now that's... he should be on 10. Which he's not. So 10 would be a much better number for me, because that's really just one attack. So I'm still in rough shape. I also think that I should pitch the king. I still have the single king. That's not a good card for me here. At least if I kept the ace back, I might be able to either draw another ace or something like that. I played a couple attacks, so I thought it was a safe time to block here. Especially with him being at the life total he's at, I could go the rest of the way with just playing attacks to finish it up. But... So, what are you going to do? Now, I'm in even a worse position after the previous block I played got thrown. I do have the second king, but no final 30 backup, and 4.0 speed is not very good against sets. It's basically just like throwing a raw 10, hoping that he's going to throw. Really, pretty much any combat win is death here. Was able to dodge by throwing out the block there. Queen's really the only viable attack I have, unless I think he's going to throw. So I'm thinking at this point, either throw out the queen or throw out another block. The danger about throwing out another block is that throw's definitely in his range here. So I think the 3 would have been... Either the 3 or the Q would have been the best choice. Luckily, the block was still better. Worked out. So really, it's the same. It's the same turn. It's either the Q, the block, or the 3. Something can be said here for the dodge, but the dodge isn't going to let me win the game, so I don't think it's a good one here. So he does go with the third dodge in a row, I believe. So pretty much this is automatic face down. Doesn't matter whether I have the Joker or not. He knows that, so he's going to try to go for the win. Got it. So luckily that play that I lost the 6 damage didn't come into play. Like, if he was sitting on 6, I would have been pretty salty. At this point, I really have lost faith in my own Imaru, so I went right into Zane. I had success with Zane in quick match, so I feel like I know Zane well enough. And even my even the meaties, even though I can be met with this 1.0 ace, it's still a good trade. And you know, getting a little Zane love from Rez. Of course, the quintessential Zane player. And he's just a quintessential player altogether. But anyway, 10 dodge right off the bat. My plan was to go right in the crash bomb. Pulled off an ace, unfortunately, in the other ace. That would have been a decent thing to do too. But got him on his back. Dodge is no longer an option. I don't think he powered up, but yeah. I mean, this is basically an auto power up for an ace, just to compete with the meaty throws, or the meaty attacks. The only meaty attack option I have so far is the 6. I do have another crash bomb. So I'm thinking at this point, he's going to play the ace. I'm going to play the crash bomb and to beat the ace. It turned out he was going to throw instead. So a meaty there actually would have been good. But instead, I went ahead and take a 20 point. You know, first two turns, 20 points off. That puts me in a good, solid spot right off the bat. Hand's not great. Don't really make great leads here. Really, the dodge is the only lead I got. Didn't really remember the ace, so I kind of end up clashing. I think the dodge would have been a bit better one, just to get the shenanigans, just to see if I can get something off of that. Already calls for the MA. Maxim fraudage. Which, that was in the game plan. Definitely the pokes are in 5X game plan. Works really well here. I think it was an evaluation thing for him to get the straight down. I'm left with kind of a pseudo poor hand now. Could block, could do the, and now the 5 is another opportunity to throw. 4 cards left in hand is a good throw range, I feel, because dodge is definitely something that's kind of gone up in value for sets. Go with the 10. I think that's fine. I think either have been fine. I did expect him to dodge himself. Instead, he 10 throwed me, which is pretty rough. I'm thinking definitely should have powered up those 8s. I think I was looking, waiting for the third 8, but it's not like I'm going to be drawing a ton of cards. So I'm not really going to be blocking much. So just having the second ace in hand to have Slipstream available would have been better than just keeping the one ace and hoping that Slipstream came up from shenanigans. I fall to the mix-up. That's the other reason to power up the eights. I at least would have had Slipstream to lead with from the knockdown, which is not the best because he does have the 1.0 speed and the 0 speed queen, but that wasn't really a spot for him to do either. He's really saving those aces against my knockdowns and when he gets to that big combo. I got poked again. There's not much more to say about that. I think 5X just put the good reads on me. I don't think the 5 was a bad... It wasn't a bad spot for the 5 there. There are other options, but it was a fine option. Of course, somebody can tell me that I'm completely wrong, and which is fine, because I don't expect to be playing Zane again anytime soon. Not that I dislike Zane. I actually think Zane's a cool character, as far as the way it plays. Definitely plays with that anarchy feel, but not really... not really something I want to deal with right now. So I did get the slipstream this time. I don't know why I played the 3. I should have played the 7. I think maybe I was thinking face down, but if I was really going for it, I was going to just say, eh, with the Joker, it was better to play the 7 into the aces. I mean, that Q's not doing me any good. I think about the only thing I was thinking is like, well, what if I need a linker later? I think I need to stop thinking about later sometimes and just get in the damage I need to, especially against a Sasuke with low life. There's not much later if I'm winning the game. So it's much easier to think about all these things post than it is during the match. Yeah, it was all about the 3 poke there. So this is a particular point where it actually worked out. I don't know what I'm doing here. Why am I not? Okay. Just a strictly worse combo. Should have gone the Q into the 6 into the jack. The turnover jack. Q in the 6 would have been 13. And 5 more damage would have been at 19, which is within range of slipstream. So that's a misplay. That's one thing about going over these videos after the fact. It's nice to kind of see, did I screw up or not? Yeah, that was just a meaty play. Try to trade out some damage. If I had done that correctly, you'd be at 13, which is even a better manageable number. This is a particular game where even those mistakes, I'm still in there. Like, I'm 18 points away. He is now within the slipstream phase. So I'm in a good spot. Yeah, and I got outpaced with the 2. I think he was thinking throw. Unfortunately, I didn't have a single throw in my hand. Otherwise, I probably would have done that. Dodge would have been easy to do had I had the other ace, but I didn't really have a way to get it. I'm thinking I should have faced down the Creator Destroyer. Not going to use it at this point. Although, again, Sets is not really going to respect face downs often. It's like you have it or you don't. So there's the throw. At this spot, pretty much it's he susses out the throw or he doesn't. Because I really don't have anything else here. I have a dodge into a 7. I have a dodge into the possibility of drawing a slipstream. Because I think I still have the 4th ace in the deck. That's pretty RNG. So I think my chance to win here is by playing the 5 throw. And it's up to him to decipher whether he's going to play an attack to poke me, or if he's going to dodge, or what was he going to do. I think his range is more attack-based here. Which I correctly did figure out. And bought myself an extra turn with a Joker draw. So that's kind of nice, since I lost the first one to Shenanigans. Thanks, Shenanigans. Okay. Now, the question is, if I survive this combat and the game's not over, do I power up those 4s? Because that should have been an easy windmill. Power these up, get the second ace. Throw here is good. I got the Joker back up. Even when he hits me, I got a chance to. And he does. And I'm thinking either he doesn't have it or he correctly deciphered that it was a good throw at Joker. And by the way, those 4s are still sitting in my hand. They should be gone. Now dodging the ace is not a possibility. So that's a huge, huge, huge misplay. Because now I have very little options to get me into the 18 damage I need for the win. Gonna poke out a throw from him. He throws the the queue. Not sure what I was thinking. I'm thinking the game's over here. And then all of a sudden, what? Did he really have nothing? Did he really fall for the third Joker trick? I found out later. He did not fall for the third Joker trick. It was his hand was fairly poor. He had nothing to follow up with, so I'd still been sitting at two. So whether I was at six or two didn't really matter. But at least six put me in range of the throw. Block down another cue. Why are those four? Okay, finally. Finally got those throws, except now I got those up my hand for the ace, which I couldn't even draw, by the way. I just realized that there were still, those all three aces were in my discard. Now I don't have the dodge. The dodge is gone. So now what am I going to do? I'm going to sit here and die. I can throw out Slipstream. Hope he doesn't play something under. Like he plays. No, I looked. He has no twos left. Okay. Now I'm in a checkmate situation. I can't block. Because that would lose to the ace. I can't play my aces raw because I will lose to the ace. I did draw a dodge. So dodge here is my play. The only play I have left is the dodge because his ace is a checkmate for me. And so I can't play any other things. So now is my opportunity to win. So I go ahead and throw out the 19 damage. He turns over the Joker. Salt. So that easily could have been a win, despite bad plays. He may have had that Joker earlier when I could have played that play several turns before. He may not have. He may have drawn into it. Either way, I still made a pretty big mistake. When it came down to time, I made the right call, but got Jokered. So he doesn't have any twos left. He still has his ace. I still cannot play a block. I have to play an attack because the throw is no good. And there it is. Actually, he may not have had aces because he played the ace and I dodged it. So yeah, couldn't kill with the five cards in hand. Not sure what his hand was. It'd be a good hallmark play to figure out what the hell his hand was. And this is me. He's saying, "Oh, you didn't fall for the third Joker trick then." Already sent with two aces in hand. It's good. I got a stealthy Slipstream phase. And at this point, I'm pretty much all in with Zane. If I win, I have to stick with it, and I have to win four games in a row. So Zane's the guy the rest of the way here. Could dodge in the aces. Could red the two, although the two's not really good here. The eight's not the best. So I just go ahead and block. Which works out. Zane with a big hand can get kind of scary. Really like dodging with the 10s when they come up. I really don't have many other things to lead, so why not? You know, may pull something off of shenanigans that'd be worthwhile. I got a 6 and a 9. The 9 is a pretty good one. It's actually the best thing I have besides the aces. And I think that's why I was thinking, do I want to throw the 9? Do I want to throw the aces? You can make an argument for either. Let's get in the damage while I can. But I think those aces silence a better idea. So I go ahead and power up and decide I'm going to go for Maximum Anarchy. Might as well make a big splash if this is going to be my last game for this series. So there's ace number three already. Two are silent. He might have sussed out I already had the other two aces. Possibly even three, because I only went for one ace instead of two. Or at very least, I have one behind, so I have two aces in hand for slipstream. So I think he knows that. When one ace doesn't do anything for you, if somebody powers up for one ace, usually they're going to. It's somewhat of a tell that you have at least another one behind. At least that's what I'm thinking at this point. Another block. Most of that, I think, is hand. I could have crash bombed there, which would have been perfectly fine. Now I'm definitely thinking crash bomb because I have the nine. I also could, so I could dodge into it, so I can do meeting nine and get a good trade. So that's what I go with. I also could have played the crash bomb by itself. It's the same thing. It beats the faster stuff. The only thing it does beats the block. At this point, I'm thinking, okay, well, I don't have to play the crash bomb. I have a jack. And I think when the jack comes up, you just have to use it. It's not like I can get that back. So maximize the amount of knockdowns I can make. So the one damage difference isn't going to make that big of a difference. I think I'm on the same plan. I could meaty the nine right now and trade, or I could crash bomb. I don't know why I'm thinking five throw. I definitely would think five dodge. But worst thing that happens here is we trade damage, which I'm perfectly fine with. He wasn't, though. He played the queen, which is a good play. Undercuts my one speed. Face down here. It's weird with sets. He's going to play out what he's got. So face downing really isn't going to do much, face down bluff. But I think you still need to do it once in a while, because if you don't and you just do it when you have it, he's gonna be like, okay, he's got the Joker, I'm just going to wait till the next turn to dump my hand. Unless the hand's really bad, then he's just going to dump it anyways. But pretty much I value the Creator Destroyer as a dodge in this matchup. It's not like he's building a hand towards something. He's just getting what he's getting off of Speed of the Fox, so there's no reason. So I think I was looking to dodge into the K. Got nothing off Shenanigans, so it's Crash Bomb time. Which he successfully jokers. His jokers have been really, really good this match. Something like 40, 50 damage he jokered out on me. And I think that's the annoyance of Setsuke, is that she's going to play the face down every single time. And you just have to play it that it's not a joker. And sometimes you're right and sometimes you're not. Some of the older players may have figured it out when's the joker time and when isn't, but at this point I don't know that. So I get another dodge, so another combat win. This time I'm not really sure what I'm dodging into, to be honest. I think I should have just played the two block, especially since I was going into have a Maximum Anarchy and I used up a dodge for no reason. I basically used the dodge as like, maybe I'll pick up something from Shenanigans. So that, I think, was a mistake. Now it's, when do I play Maximum Anarchy? He has played a lot of attacks. I haven't seen as much dodging. And I think a lot of that has to do with throws. So here I decided to go right for it, and I hit it. So there's a game for me. I don't know what nobody was saying on that. And I never went back and checked. Yeah, plan B is good. I was just kind of curious who was in. We had a decent group. We had Hartley, the People's Champ. We have Julie. We have I Am Nobody. We have LK, Mr. Gloria himself. Or maybe it's her. I have no idea. Sorry. We have the old-timers, Razik and Raziak. Sorry. Razik. Jeez. Raziak and Riker. I think Wampa's been around a little bit, maybe. I think I've seen that name a few times. Maybe I'm confusing them. But Riker and Raziak are like... They've definitely been around a lot. They're probably two of the most knowledgeable guys in and I definitely like Riker's commentary. The one with Mystic Juicer and with the Hartley match against Raziak was very entertaining, even though an hour of it was just the Riker Mystic show. No Yomi being played for like an hour before the match finally happens. So there's the trade again after the... Or what the hell did I do that time? Crash Bomb. Was there a Crash Bomb again? It's a pretty good hand. And I already got him down within maximum anarchy range, basically. Although I only have one ace this time, and nothing really to get other aces with. So plan A is not... plan B is not really in style. I have two jacks, which is really good. Yeah, I'm thinking 5-throw here. I could also dodge into the 9. Yeah, and I went with the dodge. Not dodge into the 9. Dodge into the 9 damage and knockdown from the jack. Nothing great from shenanigans. This is one thing about dodge and the shenanigans. Which may change my evaluation on that play. What am I going to dodge into that's better than the jack? The only thing I can think of is an ace. The ace is about the only thing to come off. I think that would be better. Maybe Crash Bomb. Actually, has to be Crash Bomb. Has to be better because if it did come up, I would have played that instead. I think at this point, I've been very throw... throw scared. He's been poking me out pretty good. He's also been saving those cues for the meaties. But I have been able to get a decent amount of damage in. Unfortunately, he's starting to trade up again now with that cue. Really not much left to talk about as far as the match goes or anything else. I think it's just... you know, how I'm evaluating these hands. Really, it's the 5 is the only play I have. It's, do I throw, do I dodge? After Speed of the Fox turns, dodge is a more likely card to be played. And the 5 does beat his throws. So, I think it was the right end to play. Unfortunately, I did not get anything good off shenanigans, so I can play the jack. So, just have to play the 2 and be happy with that. Still 17 damage. It's not great, but 25 is definitely within the realm of possibility. And I get the 4th jack, which normally I'd be happy to see. Here, it's not good. 2.8 speed is terrible. 4.0 speed is terrible. The only thing I could think of is if the Q hits and I draw an ace, that's game. And no Joker, of course. Which is the play I make. This at this point should show that my hand is very poor. I think it's fairly certain that I'm not capable of evaluation trapping yet. I'm not even capable of evaluation. I think I'm evaluation trapped myself a few times. But I don't know the evaluations well enough to make those kind of plays yet. I do know they exist. I do definitely want to get into them. I just need to, I think, figure out the game first. This is another big boner of mine that I made. I let time run out. It chose my card for me. It worked out. But quite honestly, if you look at it, it's the only play I can make. A consideration here would have been to dump the jacks for ace, to have two aces, to threaten the aces. Which may have allowed me to get in a throw. I think at this point he knows that I'm trying to build a hand back up because I blocked. He may not have noticed that I ran out of time there. Either way, it would have been the move I made. No, I think I'm stuck. I think I have to throw the five. I think the five is the only relevant thing I can throw here. It does give me the potential to win. It beats his throws. It beats his potential dodge. One of the worries I have, though, is there's one queen that has been played at. That jack's pretty fast, too. But it's the queen I'm really worried about, which is why I go into the dodge, which ended up being correct. The only problem with the dodge is there's no shenanigans I'm going to get that's going to win me the game. By playing a jack here, I eliminate my possibility of getting an ace. If I had played the six, it would have put him at 19, which means I could have powered up for the ace and put him on a 50-50. Either I dodge into the ace and, you know, he tries to attack and I win, or I ace straight and he does something else. Although I still don't think that, it's not really 50-50. He's got the queen. It doesn't win, so I don't know. But I think playing the six would have been a better choice. So I get another dodge. I'm taking too many turns to get him down from 25. Here's an easy thing. I got a crash bomb off shenanigans. Play crash bomb. It's that simple. It's a Joker. Nothing much I could do about that. There's another 10 points of damage he saved off a Joker. His blue boosts were playing clutch. Once he got it off a win, but saved a bunch of damage during my owning games. So, yeah, he had some pretty clutch Jokers this match. he definitely outplayed me, though. I mean, it's hard to win against somebody that not only is outplaying you, but also is getting really good things going his way. And the blue bursts were definitely going his way. All right, so now he's in with a 9. Dodge sets me up for a win. A throw sets me up for a win because I have anything I can play off the throw. I guess the throw doesn't set me up for a win. Neither does, because he still could have the Joker. The throw would put me in range of chip damage, although, again, I don't think I've seen a single block. Yeah, I don't think I've seen a single block from Satsuki. That could be wrong. I think maybe there was one turn he blocked the entire match. I'm really not sure what that block is. I really think it was either the throw or the five. or the throw of the dodge. I think that was a mistake. Not a block is not going to let me win. It just gives him another turn to draw into something. Another turn. So. So I do the dodge, I think, here. One turn too late. Oh, there's that block I was talking about. Which is unfortunate I didn't choose the throw side. Because that still also would have been a legitimate... a legitimate choice. All aces are in yard. Still two queens. Now I don't have the five to beat his throws with. I've shown dodge last turn. Yeah. Good game. I almost just hit pass and just said, yeah, just kill me. But at this point, he's got enough for 17 damage, no problem. So another game I got him close to the end, but didn't quite seal the deal. Definitely could have been 3-2. No Joker that game at all for me. So with 22 cards left, so that was pretty bad. But anyway, thanks for watching. I think I'm gonna start showing some games on Twitch, some of my grave games, my grave practice games, because that's what I'm gonna be playing now, I think. Maybe some Gwyn too. We'll see which one I end up going with my next matches. But anyway, thanks everybody, and see you next time.